Hi, this is Stephen Gregg, and we're on part 15 of The Mindset of a Trailblazer. And what happened was the next year was the new year. And at the end of 2017, the Lord began to share some things with us about things that we didn't see coming. We didn't know this was going to happen. We didn't know what the Lord was doing, but we just saw some signs. And there were so many signs that were going on in the world and going on in the sky. And, you know, there was four blood moons the year before that landed on God's feast days. And we knew something was going on because that's unusual. But we just didn't know what was happening. But one big sign that happened that year, there was an eclipse that went all the way across the United States. But, you know, the moon usually doesn't go east to west to east. It goes east to west. And this year, the moon moved west to east. And it was a big solar eclipse. And it happened to be on the Feast of Trumpets that year. And it was really interesting because we didn't know the meaning of it until God started to reveal it later on in Scripture and start revealing what was going on. But that year on the Feast of Trumpets, it was interesting because it was the same day that year that the Jews, that called themselves Jews, had their feast day on the same exact day. And that was pretty rare. That didn't happen that often. But it was really rare that it happened with that eclipse. And so we're like, what the heck is God doing? And it was really interesting because, let me just kind of backtrack a little bit. In the year 2016, at the end of the year 2016, something amazing happened that kind of preceded all of this stuff. But the people that called themselves Jews did something very interesting and really weird. I thought it was strange. They added a 13th month at the end of the year. So, like, you know, you get to the end of the 12 months of counting on God's calendar, they added a 13th month. And I was like, what the heck is that? 13th month? Who adds a 13th month? There's no 13th month in Scripture. So I Googled it. I looked up Bible Gateway. Couldn't find a 13th month anywhere in Scripture. So I said, we're not doing that. We're not following that at all. So that whole year, we were off of the calendar with the Jews that whole year. Up until it got to around the Feast of Trumpets. And then we were honoring the Feast of Trumpets at a different time. And something put it on my heart to look up this thing called a new, you know, what the month of Aviv. Because I don't know what it was, but somebody either said the month of Aviv or I saw a scripture on it or something. And I was like, what the heck does a month of Aviv mean? And so it showed in Scripture where at the beginning of every year, we have to go look and see if the barley was Aviv. Because that's when we can start our year based on the next new moon after the barley's Aviv. So what I did was I went back and I looked back at the beginning of that year. And found out that that was the reason why the Jews added another month, because the barley wasn't Aviv that year. And so that month, so they had to add another month before they could start the year for Passover. And I was like, wow, okay, I get it. So you know what I had to do? I had to humble myself, and I went to the ministry, and I said, hey guys, you know, we've been off a month. And so I know we honored the Feast of Trumpets already and everything, Day of Atonement's coming up, but we're going to have to do it again because the Feast of Trumpets is actually next month and the Day of Atonement is next month, not this month. And so we did it. We honored the first month and then we went back and did it again the next month because, you know, God showed us in Scriptures. And that was one of the things I made a commitment to. If I see something in Scripture, then amen. I don't care if I have to humble myself and put my tail between my legs and say we were wrong, because we were absolutely dead wrong that year. And we did. We went back and we honored Day of Atonement that year. And it was really cool because, you know, a lot of powerful things happened to me that year. You can watch some of our other videos and hear about it. But it was pretty amazing because God showed us that, you know, that year now started correctly. So now we are finally right on the right calendar. And He showed us that He started to teach us things about the Mark of the Beast that year. And He started showing us how the Mark of the Beast in the month of Aviv and the Passover and all that was all tied together. And I didn't know how it was tied together yet. But God started revealing to me that the month of Aviv was a very important feast. Because if you look in Exodus 13, verse 1 through 9, it starts talking about that the feast days, which is Passover and Feast of Unleavened Bread, it needs to be on your hand and on your forehead. And we know that in the book of Revelation, in 12, 13, 14, the mark of the beast is on your hand and on your forehead. And we started studying this out, and we were like, wait a minute, how is this tying together? And something wasn't right, but we knew something, God was doing something amazing. But that year, God started implementing, He started showing us some things that started to become very easy to see. He taught me how the bride of Christ is now going to be separate from everyone else. So what ended up happening that next year, which was after that year we celebrated, you know, the feast days on the same year, then the next year, something else happened. At the end of the year, it was time to go look out for the month, the barley again. So then this year we went out and we personally didn't go look out for the barley because there's no barley where we live. So we had to look online for people that was honoring the, you know, barley. And it was interesting because that whole last month, the whole 12 month, for the entire month, we were looking for the barley. The Jews, people that call themselves Jews, were looking for the barley. Other people were looking for the barley. No one could find any of the barley. And then right at the last day, right before the new moon was going to show, that the barley, this one group saw the barley of Eve. Now it was a small patch, a little patch of barley. And they said, well, there's barley of Eve, so they're going to start the month. And I said, we're going to do it too, because the Bible doesn't say how much barley needs to be of Eve. It just says it needs to be of Eve. So by faith, we said, well, we saw that person. And then there was another group that saw the barley being of Eve that year. So we decided, you know what? The barley's of Eve, we're going to obey it, because it doesn't say how much barley of Eve. But then the people that call themselves Jews, they decided, you know what? They're not going to celebrate it that year. They're going to go ahead and put it a month off. They're going to do it the next month, which is kind of like what the Pharisees and teachers of the law did back in the day. They would come up with their own ways to honor it. So this year, in Passover, we honored Passover for the first time that I know of in history differently than the people that called themselves Jews. God completely separated us out, completely. And we're now honoring the Feast of Trumpets, and we've honored the feast days this year 1 month earlier than everyone else did. And then there's a lot of people that call themselves Hebrew Israelites. There's a lot of other people that follow the Jewish Saturday Sabbath that is not anywhere near God's Sabbath, which is based on God's calendar. So this year, for the first time, we are completely separated out. And so we started teaching this to our ministry. And the brothers in India and Africa, people started coming from all over the world, from Africa and India and different parts of the country, even South America. People started seeing the message. People started seeing it and obeying it. They started obeying the Sabbath day based on that. And so Passover, we had an awesome Passover. And we showed in Scripture how it was separated. And then now we're getting towards the Feast of Trumpets. And it's amazing. We have so many pastors. I think we have 14 or 15 pastors in India and Africa, in different parts of Africa, all taking this message to hundreds, if not thousands of people, so they can start honoring the Feast of Trumpets this year based on God's calendar. God has separated his bride out, separated his people out in Africa and India completely so that we're on a totally different calendar. And it was interesting because last year when the Feast of Trumpets landed, it landed on 9/11. And it was interesting because last year when it landed on 9/11, what we did was we did a research to find out what was 9/11, why was that significant? And we found out that the same year, 2,000 years before, on that same day, 9/11, 7th, September 11th, that was the same day that the grapes were supposed to be harvested. We found that out based on Google, that the grapes were supposed to be harvested on 9/11 that year, that the year that the Israelites were supposed to go into the Promised Land, but they didn't go in. But 2,000 years later, 9/11, on September 11th, the Feast of Trumpets landed. And that year we celebrated, and God brought about 5,000 people to honor the Feast of Trumpets last year. And so we were like, wow, God was doing something amazing. He gave us donations. He had people donate a little bit of money to us. We donated, you know, just a few thousand dollars. But he turned those few thousand dollars into over 5,000 people he taught the message to. That was last year. But this year, it's amazing. The same thing that's happening right now. We believe God is bringing his sheep to his ark. We believe God is bringing his sheep to his ark. And I can't wait to tell you what's going to happen and what's happened this year. Because last year, that's what happened. He showed us 9/11. He showed us how September 11th was such a significant day that the giants of those days scared off the Israelites from going into the Promised Land. But 2,000 years later, he showed us that he's bringing his people back to learn the covenant, to learn about the mark of the beast, and learn how his true Sabbath days and holy days work. And he showed us how he separated us out this year. So I can't wait to tell you on the next video what actually has happened since then. So thank you again for listening to this message. You guys have no idea what God is doing right now, but he's looking for his people that really want to know the truth. And if you're watching this video right now, I really hope you're really getting what God is doing. Because he's looking for his people that want to obey him. He's looking for his people so he can take them to the kingdom of God. Please subscribe to our channel. Click the bell so you can get, you know, the announcements when we have another video up. I'll talk to you shortly.